some notable stuff happening. Elmer Valentine, the owner of Rock Club, dies at 85. Jim Morrison of the Doors, his father, Admiral Morrison, commander of destroyers at the Gulf of Tonkin, very instrumental kind of in world history with the Vietnam War. He kicked the bucket. And Dennis Yost, the I guess he was the lead singer for the American rock group, the Classics Four. He also croaked, and he left 5 children and a wife. You know, the Classics Four, they recorded Spooky, Stormy, and Traces of Love. Real Schlockmeisters with a tinge of psychedelica. But I guess most important in rock history was Elmer Valentine. And Elmer Valentine was a self-described crooked cop originally out of Chicago. He was a bag man for the mob, it looks like. But he came west and he started a new life on Sunset Strip with the Whiskey A Go-Go. Now, the cause of his death was heart failure after 4 years of heart ailments. It was reported by his business associate, Lou Adler, who you could find sitting next to Jack Nicholson at the Lakers games every night. I think that's Lou wearing a beard and a fancy hat all the time. Whiskey Go-Go was a bank building that Mr. Valentine turned into one of the first discos, or a hip disco, and one of his innovations was putting a girl in a cage and doing a go-go dance. And for those of you who never been out to the Sunset Strip, the Whiskey might still be there. It was located at Clark Street and Sunset. Ever went up Clark Street? That was a hip street where a lot of hipsters lived, and they were all assholes. Whoever I ever met on Clark Street, there was never a nice person up on Clark Street. Just shitheads. I don't know how they got the money to rent apartments up there, but they did. The Birds, the Doors, Sonny and Cher, the Kinks, the Who, and the Mamas and the Papas were all regular fans playing the Whiskey. Bob Dylan would come in and shoot pool, and Jimi Hendrix would jam there. So, you know, the club had quite a reputation. Later on, when the hippies all died up and dried up, the club became it was kind of a speed metal joint, and it was very popular with the heavy metal crowd. One night there, listen to this lineup, who performed on one night at the Whiskey was the Buffalo Springfield, the Acid Band, the Arthur Lee's Love, and Van Morrison and Frank Zappa, who was originally from the Antelope Valley area. It was quite a lineup. Although I remember when I was at Woodstock one night, they had Janis Joplin, Creedence Clearwater, The Who, Sly and the Family Stone, Jefferson Airplane, I think it was, playing that night. Quite a night. My memory is gone, but that was a great night at Woodstock. And John Fogerty of Creedence Clearwater was particularly good at Woodstock. It was commented to me by one of the acid heads I was hanging out with how powerful John Fogerty's voice was over the sound system. Of course, it was late at night, everybody was tripping. Alma Valentine, who died at 85, was the proprietor of the Whiskey A Go-Go. He originally went to Paris, where he was impressed by a Paris disco called the Whiskey A Go-Go. And with his partners, he opened up the Whiskey. And later on, he opened up the Rainbow and the Roxy, also on Sunset Strip, down a few paces from Clark Street. The Roxy and the Rainbow were closer to Doheny, and the Rainbow, kind of the Rainbow was the restaurant upstairs where the Rockies would go and get smashed on booze and pick up chicks, and the Roxy's where they performed. Anyway, that's Alma Valentine, you know, and one of his girls there, Janet Levine, was in the, in fact, Johnny Rivers was in the house band, Johnny Rivers band, and Johnny was also a DJ there, I guess, and Alma had the idea to play songs in between sets, and, you know, recorded songs, which I guess maybe that was an innovation, and that spread around. I hated that. You know, and nothing made me madder than playing a set and then having, you know, recorded music go on between the fucking sets. You know, why have the fucking band there to begin with? But I hope we're not running too late on time here. Dennis Yost, they call themselves the first soft rock band, so I guess that has a big to do in rock history. It looks like he was a drummer, you know. He came up from Jacksonville, Florida to Detroit when he was 7 years old. And some of the classics for later became the Atlanta Rhythm Section, and he had to fight after he anyway, Mr. Yost became a solo act and he pursued other business interests, and he had to fight a long battle to get the name of Classics 4 back. And of course, Admiral Morrison and Jim Morrison really didn't have much to say to one another, as they were, Jim Morrison didn't want his family particularly involved in his career as a rock musician, and of course one of the most influential and best ones there was.